Hi guys, salut tout le monde. So let's practice pronouncing French pastries today. All these words are a great exercise for pronouncing very French sounds like re, en, un, un. You find it all in those words. Let's start.
If you enjoy this video, please like, subscribe, and feel free to ask us any questions you may have down in the comments below. Also, be sure to visit us at streetfrench.org for more resources to help you learn French.
First one is le croissant. Le croissant. Or le croissant au beurre. Croissant au beurre. Le pain au chocolat. Le pain au chocolat. Pain. Un. Le pain au raisin. Le pain au raisin. Again, that un sound. Un is the same sound as un, deux, trois. Un. Pain au raisin. Pain au chocolat. Ok? Next. Le chausson aux pommes. Le chausson aux pommes. Chausson. It's actually my favorite. Oh my god, I love it so much. Next one, la brioche. La brioche. You have to pronounce the R a little bit. It's not too hard of a R, it's subtle. Brioche. The next ones are not as famous, unfortunately, but they were a big like staple when we were kids, so there's la viennoise au chocolat. La viennoise au chocolat. It looks like a baguette, but it's kind of a brioche bread with a chocolate inside. And les chouquettes. Do you know les chouquettes? I'm not sure everyone knows about it, but it's really good. It's really great. It's usually what people buy when they bring pastries or viennoiseries to their friends or to work. A lot of people buy chouquettes, like a big bag of chouquettes. Les chouquettes. It's actually the same dough as les éclairs au chocolat, but there's nothing inside and it's just sugar on top. So all these were called les viennoiseries. Viennoiseries. And it's different from les pâtisseries. Pâtisseries are the cakes kind of things, like the desserts. So viennoiserie is something you would eat for breakfast, but it's like a fancy breakfast. It's like on Sundays, on some occasions, because it's too heavy, it's not really good for you. We don't eat that every day, it's a myth, but it's really good, we love it. But we can eat that also for like a snack during the day. In France, there's a word for that, it's called le goûter, and it's at 4 p.m. Kids have a little break at school and they eat le goûter, so their moms or their parents prepare something for them, like a little juice and maybe a fruit and sometimes un pain au chocolat. So let's talk about les pâtisseries. Les pâtisseries. What you have to know about this pâtisserie and not the viennoiserie, les pâtisseries, we don't eat that for breakfast. Even though it's in the bakery, la boulangerie, not everything is just breakfast food. Because I know I've met people who thought French people would eat un éclair au chocolat for breakfast. Like, that's not what we do. That's dessert. That's what we eat at the end of a meal. And yeah, let's start with everyone gets this one wrong. So this is how you pronounce it. Le millefeuille. Le millefeuille, millefeuille, and it means a thousand papers or a thousand layers. This one is opéra, opéra. Then you have la tarte tatin, la tarte tatin. I know they serve that in some restaurants in the States, and I've heard people saying tarte tatin, and they pronounce the N, but that's not how we say it. The right pronunciation would be la tarte tatin. Tatin. So I pronounced it earlier, but I'll say it again. You have also the éclair au chocolat, ou éclair au café, un éclair au chocolat, un éclair au café. Les fameux macarons. Le macaron. Tout le monde adore les macarons. Tout le monde parle des macarons. Les macarons. This cake, I really love it, but I haven't had it in a very long time. I don't know why. But it's called le fraisier. Le fraisier. In French, strawberry is une fraise, so you get the cake un fraisier. Next one, le flan. Un flan. Flan. It's the same sound as croissant. Flan. Croissant. Flan. Okay? Next one, it's une religieuse. Une religieuse. Okay, so this one is called un Paris-Brest. Paris-Brest. And actually, so you recognize the name Paris in the name of the cake, but Brest is another town and it's in Brittany at the far west of France. Next, un cannelé. Un cannelé. Cannelé. The next one, we have a lot of versions and I'm sure you have too in your countries, in the States or wherever, is la tarte, a pie. La tarte aux pommes. Une part de tarte aux pommes, s'il vous plaît. Une part de tarte aux pommes, s'il vous plaît. And then now they're making smaller pies and it's called tartelette. Tartelette. It just means petite tarte. Tartelette. Small pie. And you have the famous tartelette citron meringuée. Une tartelette citron meringuée. And the last and not least, it's really not my favorite at all, but everyone, I don't know why everyone knows it, but maybe because of the tarte au citron meringuée, is la meringue. La meringue. Meringue. Okay, so that's it guys. It was me pronouncing 20 French pastry for you. I hope it was helpful that you can practice pronouncing those very French sounds like the r, r and the un sounds, all the nasal sounds. All these names are a very good practice, I think. Actually, tell me in the comments which one is the hardest one for you to pronounce. I kind of want to go buy some for myself right now. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoy learning French with us, you can now support us on Patreon. It's a space where you can ask us anything, we do exclusive live stream, and you even get rewards. We really want it to be like an online learning community where Charlie and I are your French online teachers. Please check it out if you can donate $2 or more. It would really help us a lot. Thanks again for watching. Please subscribe if you're new here. And share this video with your friends who are also learning French. And for more French lessons, head on to our website streetfrench.org to try our free French e-course. Okay, salut, bye bye!